What's up, fight fans? This is Kurt DeVille with Counterpunch Boxing News, and I have some new news concerning the Gypsy King, Tyson Fury. He has gave Deontay Wilder a warning and stated that much can happen between now and January when he is expected to rematch with Deontay Wilder. He goes on to say, he says, I can say anything. Look, he's Wilder, talking about a fight that's a year away. He told Rich Eason show, on the Rich Eason show. Anything can happen. We're not promised tomorrow, so I'll live for today. Because of the background that I've come from and what I've suffered, that I'm suffering with, I can look past today because tomorrow I might be in total depression. Again, so I only have to live for today and be happy for now, and that's how I get through. He says Deontay Wilder is talking about fights that could happen in 2020. I have not even fought my fight on Saturday yet. I could get knocked out in that one. We never count chickens before they hatched. He, which is Wilder, has to have the to get past Luis Ortiz, and I'm probably going to fight September or October. I don't know against whom. I don't get involved in it too much. When I've got the fight on the horizon, I don't look past that initial fight. That is the words from Tyson Fury. And you know, to counterpunch Tyson Fury, he's absolutely right. I do respect how he included himself with the warning he gave to Deontay Wilder. Not only we don't know what can happen between now and their bout, we don't know if he'll win Saturday. We don't know if Luis Ortiz won't knock out Deontay Wilder. Did it get close to happening? Yeah. Yes, it did. Very much so. Let's put it this way. Luis King Kong Ortiz came closer to knocking out Deontay Wilder than Dillian White came to knocking out Anthony Joshua when they fought. So that's a little food for thought. You know what I'm saying? So think about that. And Tom Swartz, I just looked at his media workout, and he doesn't look slow. I don't know how the hell Tyson Fury can compare him to George Foreman. I don't see how he can do that. Maybe because they're undefeated, but George Foreman was the champion. I don't notice the reference. I don't see the similarities between the two fighters. I don't. Swartz and Foreman, no, I don't see it. But that's how Tyson Fury looks at it. We'll see Saturday night what he does, you know. But Tom Swartz looks like he's here to prove a point. And one thing I'm noticing is that in boxing, of course, we know anything that can happen. But I'm noticing a lot of these fighters that seem to have no chance are getting hungrier. They're getting hungrier to show that, hey, this is no fluke. These people are actually fucked up by picking me to fight. Look at Ruiz, for Christ's sake. It didn't happen already. Who thought that? 25-1. Who thought that at all? Okay, so I think Tyson Fury has listened to his promoter or his secondary or whatever, his manager, Frank Warren, okay? Because Frank Warren, remember last week, gave the same warning to Tyson Fury. Hey, don't take your eye off the ball. Focus on the fight in front of you. Don't worry about the fight in September. And sure to hell, don't worry about Deontay Wilder. He might be janky for all we know. We don't. But you have to focus on the fight in front of you. And that's what he informed him or advised him last week. And now Tyson Fury, I believe, is taking heed to that instruction. You know what I'm saying? And he's also added that to Deontay Wilder. And he's absolutely right. You know, Tyson Fury talks a lot of shit. Again, he talks more shit than Jesse Jackson or any politician. But he does, and he will say some things that make sense from time to time. And this is one of them. Okay? And everything that Tyson Fury says, he believes 100%. So that's what's important. But I do agree with that, counterpunching what he has to say, because I think Tyson Fury, because he acknowledges it, him comparing Swartz to Foreman, he may still be overlooking him. You know what I mean? You don't know. We don't know that. And Deontay Wilder may be doing the same thing with Luis Ortiz. And Luis Ortiz has warned Deontay Wilder, to reiterate. Okay, so the warning has been set. You know, the instructions have been laid out. will these guys follow these instructions? You know, hey, let's throw Dillian White's ass in there. The same thing can happen to Dillian White with Oscar Rivas, right? Oscar could go in there and take him out. He upset Brian Jennings. Hello. People forget about that. Brian Jennings was like the next fighter to be mandatory, I think, for I think the WBA. So, yeah. It can happen, people. You know, so Oscar Rivas is not an opponent that just got picked out of 57, 58, or 59th ranking. He's a fighter that's creeping on the come up, and he's undefeated. But guess who else is undefeated? Tom Swartz. And I'm going to leave you guys with that counterpunch. You guys tell me what you think about Tyson Fury's instruction and warning to Deontay Wilder. Of course, please subscribe. And you guys have been counterpunched. Peace.